In this video, I'm going to show how you can use this F3 menu to find dungeons which can be useful to find notch apples. If you hold shift and F3, you get a pie chart on your F3 menu. If you then press the correct number to go to tick, followed by level, followed by block entities, then it shows you all the block entities loaded in your chunks. As you can see, I currently have a mob spawner and a chest, and those are over there. But if I go ahead and break these, you'll notice that they don't initially disappear. This is because of some bug that came in 1.17. If I go ahead and just reset the F3 menu like that, you can see they have now disappeared. Use this strategy, we can find dungeons extremely, extremely fast. First thing you need to do is turn your render distance all the way down to 2. The simulation distance doesn't matter because if it's higher than render distance, then it's kind of irrelevant. And once that's done, you have to reload the world. Otherwise, it just wouldn't work. And now I'm going to use a chest to show how we can use this strategy to find things. So we're also going to turn on chunk borders with F3 and G. So we can see that in this chunk right here, there is a chest. If I go over here, you can see the chest is still loaded, so the chest hasn't disappeared. My render distance is 2, so again, if I do that, the chest is still loaded. Now, if I go over here, the chest is actually out of render distance, but the game still detects it. But if I then go another chunk this way, it's disappeared. Now, on a super flat, if I move one chunk closer, it will load back in, which even though it's out of render distance. Instead of here, I go 1, 2, and now on this third chunk, it is out of render distance, but you can see it's still loaded. I go one more this way, and it's now unloaded. I come back in and it doesn't load back in. I don't know why it's different in a super flat to a normal world, but there you go. When I now come within 2 chunks of it, as you can see, it's loaded in. So this is how we can use it to know where the dungeon is. And now I'm going to explain this in Photoshop. These squares are all the different chunks. If we are the player and we run across this chunk, then we then go to this chunk, and then we go to this chunk, and we detect a spawner. But in these 2 chunks, we didn't detect a spawner. We know that there's no spawner in either of these, but we also know with a 2 render distance on each side, that there is no spawner, so we can do that. But we also know that from here, there was no one, so there can't be a spawner there, can't be a spawner there, or in the ones at the corner, because it's a square is the render distance that loads this in. So we now know like an area of where it can't be, and basically from here, it can only be in one of these 5 squares, the dungeon chest spawner that just loaded in. If from here we now go to the right and the dungeon doesn't disappear, we can then eliminate this one here because it's no longer rendered in. If we go to the right again and it doesn't, we can then eliminate that one. And we're now stood in this chunk. So we know that it's now down to these 3 chunks at the top. So we just keep going right. If it doesn't work, we've eliminated another one. If it doesn't work again, we've eliminated another one. And then we go right to one more. I've run out of screen space, but it would then have to be this chunk. And whichever one the spawner disappeared, that's how you can work it out. So let's say I go to this chunk and it disappears. Well, what does that then tell me? It tells me it's just gone out of render distance. Which chunk just disappeared? This is the one that just went out of render distance. So we're then going to go 1, 2, 3 chunks back across, and we go 2 chunks up. So whenever it disappears, you just got to remember you go 3 chunks back where you came from and 2 upwards. I'm going to find a dungeon and show you this in action. I'll break this chest so that it's not messing with my thing. Okay, you can see we've got nothing. So we want to just keep going in a straight line until we detect a dungeon, basically. So we carry on going. We've still not detected anything. We'll keep going this way, and we want a spawner and a chest to come at the same time. Otherwise, it could be a chest from another area. And I'm not going to like take a cut or anything because I want you guys to see exactly the process that needs to happen. So again, okay, now we've picked up a spawner. Okay, now there's no chest with it. Okay, now a chest has come into view though, so it could be that the spawner is kind of in half a chunk, if that makes sense. So what we'll do now is we'll work off the chest. We'll go to the side 1 chunk. Okay, the chest is still there. We'll go again. 2 chunks, still there. So we're going to go a 3rd one. Again, it's still there. And we're going to go a 4th. Now, we go up to 5. So we've gone 5 this way. And it's disappeared. Okay, so what does that tell us? That tells us we know exactly what chunk the spawner is in. We go back the way we came, 3 chunks now. So we're going to go 1, 2. And this is the 3rd chunk here, okay? We're then going to go this way in 2 chunks, alrighty? I mean, you don't have to understand all the theory. You just have to know that you go back 3 and 2. And now we know we are in the right chunk. And if I now dig down in the center of this chunk, there's a chance for me to fall into a cave which is connected to the spawner. Or it's possible to fall into the spawner itself. You can see, unfortunately, neither of those things happened. But if we go into spectator mode, we will be able to see the spawner. And I'm going to show you where. So here's where the dungeon was. You can see it was in this chunk, but you can see, yeah, well, it just basically was in this chunk. I can narrow it down to a chunk, but as you could see, that doesn't always help us. If we want to make it more consistent, we need something called a mob switch. You can look at tutorials online to do this, but one of the easiest ways to make a mob switch is just to get loads of shulkers in your spawn chunks from a shulker farm, just duplicate them. You need about 80 shulkers, really, and I have got 80 right here. You'll be able to see if I now fly up really high that the end value is now locked to 85, so that must be how many shulkers I have. I obviously can't count, and mobs will now not spawn in the world. As you can see, it is just sticking at 85 no matter where I go. So that M counter is what we're going to use to narrow down where the dungeon is in the chunk. So as you can see, I've just found a dungeon here, so let's go to the side and still not disappeared after 3, 4, 5. So sometimes if there's more than one dungeon in an area, that will mess you up, and as you can see, it did in that case. All you do is go back to where you were, so 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the original chunk where it's loaded in. Then go the other way, and after at least 5, it should disappear. There we go. Okay, disappeared after 3. So now we're going to go back this way. 1, 2, 3. We're going to go 1, 2. It is also easy if you do it over an ocean with aqua affinity and respiration. Then you can dig down, and when you're done, you can swim back up, and there's like less structures in the way. So now I'm going to start digging down, and I just want you to watch the M counter, okay? Forget about everything else. Notice how it's on 85, okay? Now we're just going to keep digging down, and you're going to see that when we get close to a spawner, that M counter is going to change to a different number. There we go. It just changed to 88. So I am now within 15 blocks of this spawner. That's what I know. So I'm going to dig down another 10 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And look at, we actually dug straight into this one anyway, but I knew that I was close to that spawner, and if I had to dig around, I would have been able to work that out. When you finish with the dungeon, you want to break the spawner and the chest so it doesn't mess with your F3 menu. As if, we actually got a notch apple in that one as well. And you want to take out all the mobs as well. Not like a 1 in 32 chance of a chest in a dungeon having a spawner, having a notch apple in. And there's 2 chests usually in one, sometimes it's only one. So yeah, the chances of finding one are pretty slim, really. It's about 20 on average generally, but as you can see here as well, you can swim out very easily. And that's all there is to it, to find the notch apples. You might have to watch the video a few times to understand exactly what I was doing, but hopefully it was clear. If it made sense, then make sure to subscribe, leave a like, and yeah, I'll see you guys if I do another tutorial.